Inside Gaming is sponsored by ExpressVPN. Don't let hackers steal your financial details. Secure your data at expressvpn.com/inside.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to Inside Gaming Daily for Wednesday. It's a happy hump day.
Oh.
Y'all? I mean, I don't know if somebody wants to...
All right.
Get the old dog.
I definitely pulled something.
But it was worth it. Because yeah. I'm turned on. Anyway, let's talk about racist content in video games. Gaming companies now think that it's a bad thing and are vowing to clean up their act. Gaming companies? Really? Wow. Okay.
Hope you're happy, SJWs. Can't even have video games anymore. Yeah, we're seeing a lot of developers start to remove problematic or controversial imagery in their games. They're also vowing to crack down on toxic and racist players, as opposed to the decades previously that this has been going on. But now they say that stricter enforcement is on the way. The help is on the way.
And it's not just video games. We're seeing games of all sorts start to take similar steps, but we'll get to them later. The latest comes from Infinity Ward, the developer of popular Modern Warfare reboot that came out last year.
Yeah, the developer recently removed a controversial hand gesture from Modern Warfare and Warzone, much to players' surprise. What did they take out? They removed the okay hand gesture from the game without any explanation.
I'm a bit weird about that one. I feel like at some point people decided that it was a racist symbol, but I feel like that was recent.
We get into that.
Interesting you should say that.
Yeah, there's backstory.
They apparently did it very quietly and haven't commented publicly yet, and neither has publisher Activision. Eurogamer reports that it has been replaced with a new hand gesture called a crush, but there's no mention of the change in the game's patch notes.
So I can't do it below my waist anymore, and if you look at it, I get to punch you? I mean, come on.
Yeah, I can't believe they have to change the constitution to get rid of that law.
But players have definitely noticed the change, and lots are not happy. That won't surprise you. Over on the Modern Warfare subreddit, lots of people were incredulous that the okay gesture is now gone. User DJ Kada wrote, "For Christ's sake, this is going too far. Someone lost his mind in the dev team."
Sparked an old debate over whether or not the sign is actually a racist gesture. If you're not aware of the okay gesture's history, it's been around forever. But a few years ago, it got new life as a hoax on 4chan to troll the media into believing it was a symbol that meant white power. Yeah, but then, you know, I guess it worked.
The symbol took off. It didn't seem like much of a hoax anymore.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Not everyone was in on the joke.
It's a very weird one because the Anti-Defamation League has called it a hate symbol, saying by 2019, at least some white supremacists seem to have abandoned the ironic or satiric intent behind the original trolling campaign and used the symbol as a sincere expression of white supremacy. By this logic, they can take whatever symbol they want, you know?
I mean, they took Pepe from the character from Matt Fleury, I think his name
That's
was.
True.
Yeah, well, now if you wear a Hawaiian shirt, it means that you want, like, a race war to happen soon.
Wait, yeah. What?
But yeah, the okay sign got a little problematic when the white supremacist who was charged with killing 50 people in mosque shootings in New Zealand flashed the symbol in a courtroom appearance last year. So, while it may have started off as a joke or a troll, not everybody uses it in a joking manner.
Or they have a horrible sense of humor. I mean, this has happened before. Lots of symbols throughout history get co-opted by bad actors. The swastika, for example, that was a Sanskrit symbol that meant good luck, used for millennia by Hindus and Buddhists, but has a slightly different association now. That would be with the Nazis. So, and now we all basically agree that using the swastika is a bad form. It's in bad taste.
Anyway, back to Infinity Ward. This latest move is part of a wave of gaming companies cracking down on offensive behavior in the wake of the Black Lives Matter protests following the killing of George Floyd by police in Minneapolis.
Yeah, the ensuing protests caused a number of gaming companies to issue statements of support, as well as vowing to clean up behavior in their games long overdue. They made donations to various charities and social justice causes. Now some are taking a long look at racist behavior, things in their games that are problematic, and going, hey, maybe we should have taken this out a long time ago.
In other news, though, Animal Crossing let me tell my villagers to call me Big Dick. Which Nintendo's very explicit about censorship, but now they go, hey, big dick.
That's cool as hell.
Of course, racism has been an issue in video games forever, especially in online multiplayer games where racist screen names and chats filled with slurs have basically just become completely commonplace. We expect it, which is all kinds of awful. And they're also removing various multiplayer content. We'll get into some examples in a moment, but first, god damn it, we have to talk about pubes today.
Ooh. Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Manscaped. Fellas, you prepared to unveil your summer bod. Manscaped is here to ensure your post-quarantine body is ready for the wild. Don't be the guy at the beach with a bear rug on your chest. Come on. You know a lot of the other products out there, they're gonna give you nicks, they're gonna give you scrapes, you're gonna have a weird situation happening down there. Manscaped is dedicated to helping you level up your full-body grooming game. They've forever changed the game with their Perfect Package 3.0. It's a waterproof, cordless body trimmer, ton of other liquid formulations to round out your manscaping routine. It's the best trimmer on the market for those of you in need of a chest shave. This third generation trimmer features skin-safe technology to reduce manscaping accidents. Definitely don't want that. You can also adjust the settings to get the length you like, stay on top of it with almost no effort at all. You can even trim an arrow pointing to the promised land if you're bold enough. I personally probably wouldn't go for that, but you know. You can use their crop cleanser to keep your hair and skin healthy. It's an all-in-one formula, so it's good for your healthy chest hair as it is for your skin. Inside the Perfect Package, you'll also find the Manscaped Crop Preserver. It's an anti-chafing ball deodorant and moisturizer because we know how painful chafing can be when you're wearing your bathing suit all day long. So subscribe to the Perfect Package, get a new blade refill for your lawnmower trimmer delivered to your door every 3 months. For a limited time, you'll also get two free gifts, the Shed Travel Bag, that's a $39 value, and the patented high-performance reduced chafing Manscaped Boxer Briefs. We've got a good deal for you today. It's 20% off and free shipping with the code INSIDE20 at manscaped.com. Again, that is, Waylon. You want to talk about balls? You ain't got none. Again, 20% off free shipping with the code INSIDE20 at manscaped.com. 20% off free shipping at manscaped.com. Use code INSIDE20. Trim your chesticles with the besticles. All right. Thank you, Manscaped, for sponsoring today's show.
So, what multiplayer content has been removed as part of a deepening stance against racism? Well, last month, Forza announced that it would ban racers who use the Confederate flag on their cars, along with other notorious iconography. They wrote, "Our goal is to create a safe, secure, inclusive, and enjoyable experience for all players."
Some players were mad about that too, saying they were just using the flag to create cars, like the General Lee from the Dukes of Hazzard. But you can see how some people might take that flag is being offensive, to say the least.
Oh, Duke boy, it's done it again. Those them Duke boys are proliferating systemic racism through the use of iconography.
I hate this.
EA Sports recently also announced that it's taking a tougher stance on racism in its games, saying they want to, quote, maintain a culture of inclusion. They wrote, "Toxic behavior changes and evolves rapidly, and we recognize that we need to do more to actively monitor and remove those individuals who perpetuate racist, xenophobic, homophobic, or sexist behaviors in our games."
Obviously, that includes actively updating their filter list for offensive words, adding more tools to increase reporting of toxic behavior, and reviewing offenses more frequently. Toxicity has been a big problem with especially in EA Sports NHL, where lots of players have complained about problematic and racist names online.
Also last month, the trading card game Magic the Gathering, you might have heard of it, announced it was pulling several cards that had images that were racist or culturally offensive. One of the most notorious has been around since the beginning. Apparently nobody noticed a problem until now. It's called Invoke Prejudice, that showed figures in white robes and hoods. Definitely reminiscent of the KKK.
What?
Not sure how that slipped through the cracks this whole time.
Others had labels like Jihad and Pradesh Gypsies. In a statement, Wizards of the Coast said, "There's no place for racism in our game nor anywhere else, starting now."
Even Scrabble of all games is cracking down on slurs being used in tournaments. Jesus, Scrabble, who knew you had it in you? Who would have thought that giving people an endlessly random number of letters that they would go somewhere bad with it?
Back to Modern Warfare though, it's also had a lot of instances of racist and toxic behavior that have gone way beyond the okay hand gesture. Lots of people posted screenshots of racist and blatantly offensive usernames that they have let slide in the past, some just blatantly with the N-word in them.
Infinity Ward said last month they were taking a number of steps to combat racism in the game, saying that there is no place for racist content in our game. It's a case of a developer that has been pretty lax in the past about moderating users' behavior to the point where it just got totally out of control. I don't know, it seems like at least all the companies who made statements for the most part seem to actually be doing actionable things.
It's 2020, there's increasingly no place for that kind of behavior anymore. People can debate on whether or not the OK sign is racist, but there's no doubt that developers and publishers are not gonna take their chances on it.
Hey everybody, before you click away, we want to really quickly shout out our friends over at Manicore Games. They have a really cool platform called Core. It's basically a game creation tool. It's free to play, built on top of the Unreal Engine. You can basically do what's called kit bashing. You can't upload your own creations, but you can take pre-made things that are already in the game and put them together. You can change the scale, you can change the size, you can change all kinds of stuff. We're currently working with Manicore Games on their Core platform to make the Inside Gaming Daily Studio in game, which should be really cool. We should be doing a live stream with them pretty soon showing that off. Maybe, I don't know, maybe you'll see a little daily filmed in the space at some point. So it should be fun. So this morning they just announced what they're calling the Creator Payout Pilot Program. Basically, you can make money now from creating games on Core, which is really, really cool. The more people play your game that you created on Core, the more you should get paid. So I'll read a little bit from their blog announcement. It says, this means that if you have 500 unique users logging to your games every day, they do not need to be the same players. You could receive $1,500 after the end of the month. If you average 1,000 users, you could receive $3,000. If you average 10,000, you get the idea. We chose this system because we want creators to be unified in the mission of making fun games and bringing new players to Core. So if you're interested in joining, here's what they say. To participate in the program, you must receive an invite and comply with the related terms. The best way to earn one of the limited spots is to make games on Core that players enjoy. So if you have a cool game and you want to show it off, possibly make a little bit of money doing so, check out their blog post. We've linked it in the description below, and there is a link to a form that you can fill out so they can check out your game and see if you can be invited to the program. All right, well, thank you guys for checking out today's daily, and thanks Manticore Games for making such cool stuff and for making our studio for us. We're very excited to check that out. Stay tuned for that. I don't know how to close this out.
Hey everybody, welcome to Inside Gaming Daily for Thursday. It's a special Thursday. We got a special guest with us here, Cameron Hawkins. How are you doing, man?
I'm great to be here.
Good to be here. Today we've got yet another story about racism. The thing that's everywhere.
My favorite.
Nobody likes to talk about it. Yeah. Issues of racial injustice have